Welcome to part 6 of my series on the Vectric software titles for the absolute beginner. Before we get started, I'd like to say that I am neither sponsored nor endorsed by Vectric Ltd nor any other company. I'm making this series to help the person who has never done anything like this before get into the software and learn how to use it to successfully create or edit a project. In part 5 of this series, I got a little bit more advanced than I probably should have, but that was in directly because of several questions I had from several different people on the same subject. In this video, we're going to take a step back and kind of get back into some of the basics. So we'll begin by creating a new file. And I'm going to basically accept most everything that I have here. This will be a single-sided project with a 12-inch width in X, 12-inch height in Y, a thickness of 3/4 inch. Again, I'm using inches. The Z0 position will be on the material surface. And my XY datum, for layout purposes, will be in the center of the material. We'll go ahead and click OK. Now, as I've made reference to in just about every video of this series, because the Vectric software is a Windows-based program, there are several ways of doing the same thing. An example of that is resizing an object. So in this video, we're going to revisit resizing an object. In order to do that, we obviously need an object to resize, so I'm going to just simply put draw a rectangle. I'm going to anchor the center of that rectangle on my X0, Y0. So we'll go ahead and enter those coordinates there. I want the corner to be square, and I want the width to be 1.5 inches wide in X and 3.5 inches wide in Y for no particular reason. We'll click Create, then we can close, and there's our rectangle centered in the center of our project. The way I have shown you how to resize an object before was to simply select that object, come up here under Transform Objects, and set Selected Object Size, and we'll open that up. And that's fine if you know exactly what size you want to make this rectangle. If, for instance, I decided I didn't want this to be 1.5 inches wide, I made a mistake, I want it to be 2 inches wide, but I don't want to change the height, I can come up here and unlink the XY, change the width to, I believe I said 2 inches, click Apply. Because my anchor point is still the center, it stayed located in the center, but now the width of my rectangle is 2 inches and the height remains unchanged. So I can go ahead and close that. Now again, because this is a Windows-based program, I have two more ways of doing that. One is to go over here under the Edit Objects section, and you'll see we have three separate cursor pointers right here. The first one is a standard selection mode, which is what we're in right now. My cursor is just a pointer. The second one is going into node editing mode. Now that's a lot more advanced, way outside of the scope of this video, so we're not going to use it. The third way is to use the transform mode, and if you see the little text that pops up when I hover my cursor over it, transform mode, move, scale, or rotate the selection. So I'll go ahead and I'll click that icon and come over here, and you'll see now I have the four-way arrow next to my cursor. I have nothing selected, but anything I do select come over here and just click on it, and you'll see that's the appearance. We have these boxes around the outside perimeter. We have four black boxes. You'll see how my cursor changes whenever I get over one of these boxes. Then we have one in the center. The box in the center is used, you click and drag, holding your left mouse button. And that's how you would move the object around. I'm going to go ahead and hold down the control button, tap the letter Z to undo those changes, then click off. You'll notice when I click off, my cursor stays in the transform mode. I still have the four-way arrow. Click back on the object, and it lights up with these again, with these squares again. If I come up to any more of these, you'll see they change to a two-way arrow. If I click and drag, I can resize in this direction on this axis only. Let go, do Control Z again to undo that. And the same holds true for the corners. If I click and drag, I'm pulling in that direction from the corner. Even if I pull straight out to the side, it will resize in that direction. Let me hit Control Z to undo that. If I come up here to one of the black buttons, I can click and drag, and that will rotate on the center axis in whichever direction I decide to rotate it. Again, Control Z to undo. Now let's go back to these resize buttons here. Again, you have them in all four corners and on the four sizes, so you can resize to a certain point from whichever direction you want to. But if you notice, if I go back over here and I hover over this corner and click and drag, the top left corner stays anchored. It stays right there. So I'm increasing in size down towards the bottom right. Then I would have to come back up and move it up here into the center. Well, there's an easier way of doing that. Let me do Control Z to undo those changes. And come back over here, select. If I hold down the Shift key, then click and drag, you'll notice that the object expands in all directions from the center. So I can resize outward, or I can resize inward. And it anchors from the center so long as I'm holding down that Shift key. Now this comes in real handy when you want to resize something, but you don't have a specific size in mind. You just want to resize it until, quote-unquote, it looks good. This is when it comes in real handy. Now let me click off and hit Control-Z to undo that change. So that's using this icon over here under the Edit Objects tab. But you'll notice that no matter what I do, I'm still in that transform mode. So there's another way of doing exactly the same thing without using this icon. And this is what I normally would do. I'll go back to my standard select pointer. Then come over here and just click on the vector, wait a second, and click on it again. Those slow double clicks puts me into transform mode. You notice my cursor has changed. But when I click off, I go back to standard selection mode. So I never even have to come over here and hit these buttons at all. I can just select, then click again, hold down Shift, increase in size, release shift and the left mouse button, click again, then I can move on to other things. While I have this up here, I'll show you another little trick. We'll click it once, wait a second, click again, go up here into the center to move the object. But before I click and drag that button, hold down the control button. I'm holding the control button, left click on that move button, and drag a copy of that vector off to the side. So that's a quick way of copying the vector. Again, click, hesitate for a second, click again, go up to that center box, hold down control, left click and drag. And if you see my cursor, you see how it's got that circle with the crosshairs in it. That's showing me that I'm moving straight on the x-axis. I'm not moving off to one corner or the other. I'm moving straight along that axis. And there we go. So that's a quick way of resizing, a quick way of copying your objects. Hold down shift, increase in size, just until it looks good. And there we go. I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. If you got anything at all out of this video, I do hope you'll give me a thumbs up down below over here. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave them down below in the comments section. If you would really rather not leave a public comment, feel free to head over to my website, marklindsaycnc.com, and down here, click this Contact Us link. And that'll send you over to a page where you can leave me any comment that you wish. I do see every comment I get through the Contact Us form, and I try to respond to them all. Mark Lindsay CNC, the website, is sponsored by Harneel Media, the web design company that specializes in websites for the maker community. If you'd like to follow along with the rest of this series, or just follow along with some of my other CNC adventures, I do hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel. Now, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch, and y'all take care.